Hey, it's Dr. Centeno, and I am traveling this week, so I wanted to get some content out and a video out. I think what we'll do with this particular video is I do want to do Q&A, so if you can leave your questions below, I will have my assistant kind of pull all of those different questions together, and I'll do a separate Q&A video with those questions and then post that. So again, those questions can be about this content or really anything else as usual. So today we're going to talk about the accessory atlantoaxial ligament, or what I call the secondary Alar ligament. So these are the references for today's quick talk. And as I've said before, if you're interested in getting evaluated to see if you have CCI and might need either PICL or other types of injections, you know, our call center is very busy with all sorts of things. We're a large, busy clinic, so they might be seeing patients with shoulder issues or back issues or leg issues, and really the kind of problems that CCI patients have, the amount of imaging, etc., really needs a specialist. So Carla, my assistant, is a specialist in understanding all of that. So I would rather you not fill out forms either on the Regenix website or the Centeno Schultz website, but I'd rather you go directly to Carla, and her email is there. And she'll help you facilitate the process much more quickly than if you went through either call center or filled out a form online. So this is the accessory ligament. And what's interesting here is we're looking from the spinal canal towards the front. So you're seeing the back of the dens there, and I'm going to write in, this is C1, this is C2, we've got the skull way up here, and you can see this accessory ligament kind of on the back there, just to the side of the transverse ligament. So the accessory ligament here is triple A. And you've got the transverse ligament coming across the dens here. So this is a cadaver dissection. I liked it because it does show the ligament well, but it's hard to get a sense of where you are. Now this is, I think, a better view here. We've got the alar ligament up top here. And then we've got the accessory ligament in red below. And you can see that what's interesting is that the alar ligament in yellow on top goes from the dens of C2 up towards the skull. And the accessory ligament goes from C2 up towards C1 in a very similar direction. So this is why I call it the secondary alar ligament. So it's believed that this accessory atlantoaxial ligament, which is its actual name, also limits rotation at C1, C2, hence it serves a similar function to the alar ligament in stabilizing rotation at C1, C2. And these are some interesting functional drawings here. So you see the accessory ligament below there in red, and you see the alar ligament in yellow. And with head rotation, you're seeing both ligaments stabilize that rotation movement. Now, if we look at types of CCI, the rotational type, or the type involving rotation, is type 2B. So we have type 2 there, meaning involving C1, C2, and type B. So 2B is rotational instability at C1, C2. And this is some more information on that. Now, previously it was thought that this was primarily due to the Alar ligament, but as you dig deeper into the literature, you realize that the accessory ligament also plays an important role in stabilizing that. So it wouldn't be enough to just inject the Alar ligament in someone who has rotational instability. You also need to get that accessory ligament. So how is this ligament treated? Through a PICL anterior approach is the only way to get there. There's no other way to physically get into that accessory ligament. So what kind of injection do you need? Again, we'd be talking about this level 5 or 5-star injection, and that would be the PICL from the front. You're just not going to be able to get there from the back. So that concludes the information in this lecture for today. Again, if you're interested in getting evaluated, please contact Carla directly. And if you can leave your questions here, I'm going to have my assistant pull all of those together, and then I'll answer those separately since I'm traveling this week. I'm down at our Grand Cayman Clinic seeing patients down here, and I won't have as much time during the day to get online live. But what will happen is if you leave your questions here, I'll try to do a separate video and answer those questions on a Q&A. So thanks so much for watching and have a great day.